pituitary gland is the master gland, the big boss, which sends out most of the chemical bulletins through the body. It is the king of all glands as it produces hormones that instruct other glands to then produce more hormones and get the work done. So where can you find the pituitary gland? Yes, it is in the brain, but where? Very close to the hypothalamus, which is the place where the nervous system and the endocrine system basically shake hands. Its function is to tell other glands what to do based on the input it gets from your senses. So here's something really interesting. The hypothalamus has a role in milk production in breastfeeding mothers. So when the baby is crying, a sensory input, in this case auditory, travels to the hypothalamus, which nudges the pituitary gland and says, hey, there's this little bundle of joy crying nearby that might be actually hungry. The pituitary gland then stimulates the production of milk-producing hormones. This pituitary gland is actually really, really tiny. It's the size of a pea. But it produces a growth hormone also, which makes cells and thus organs and other parts of our body as big as they should actually get. Look at this man here. His name is Robert Wadlow. And he's the tallest man we have in modern day. Do you know how tall he was? He was a staggering 8 feet 11 inches. And that was because he was a pituitary giant. So we now know why that happened. It was actually a tumor in his brain that was pushing on his pituitary gland, making his pituitary gland overproduce the growth hormone and making him as tall as he actually got. Next, let's talk about the thyroid gland. Yes, those cute butterfly-shaped ones. So the pituitary gland also stimulates the production of TSH, or thyroid stimulating hormone, to, yes, you got it right, stimulate the thyroid gland, which regulates carbohydrate, protein, and fat metabolism in your body, your appetite even, and also your heart rate, and many, many more things. So the hormone that the thyroid secretes has to have a name. We can't say hormone that thyroid secretes each and every time, right? It's called thyroxin. And it does most of the things that the thyroid is stimulated for in the first place. How this functions is a typical example of what we call the negative feedback loop. Now, there's nothing negative or complicated about this loop. It's a simple secretion control mechanism in your body. The pituitary gland is sort of an automatic regulator of your thyroid gland. Say your metabolism rate is low. It stimulates the production of a bit of thyroid-stimulating hormone from your pituitary, which makes your thyroid gland produce thyroxin, okay? Now, when thyroxin is produced, this is going to in turn increase the metabolism rate. This increased metabolism rate then tells the pituitary gland to hold on with the secretion of TSH or reduce the secretion of TSH. This is called negative feedback. Okay, do you know why is iodized salt important in your diet? That is because the levels of thyroxin actually depends on the iodine available. This is really important as a deficiency of iodine can cause an inflammation of the thyroid gland. You might have heard of this condition. It's called a goiter. Next up are the adrenal glands, or the kidney hats. And as the name goes, they're going to be located just above the kidneys. Can you maybe just guess wildly what one of their functions may be because of this location above the kidneys? Adrenal glands have two functions, okay? So one is they help in maintaining the salt and water level in the body. And two, maybe you can guess this, we spoke about it in the beginning, and the name is adrenal glands, and they secrete a hormone. Can you tell me which hormone? A very famous one, yes. Adrenaline. So there is this nerve connection from the sympathetic division of the nervous system, which we spoke about, that actually ends in the adrenal gland, and that gets activated whenever you're under stress. We commonly call that the flight or the fight response. For example, when you were chased by that dinosaur again, this flight or fight response stimulates the production of adrenaline, which travels all over the body, causes different effects like the increase of heart rate, increase of BP, contraction of rib muscles so that you can breathe faster, dilation of pupils, reduction of blood supply to your digestive and reproductive systems and to your skin so that more blood is available for your muscles and your lungs, two most important parts when you decide to run. Or maybe be really brave and get into a fight with that dinosaur. If you like this video and want to watch many more amazing videos like these, like and subscribe to our channel now.